Okay, so it's telling me I have a deviated septum.
Holy nose, Batman!
Deadly aneurysms, discovering cancer before it's too late, and scanning for over 500 other mysterious medical conditions, all while you just lay there watching TV. What? Today, we're ditching the studio talking about Prenuvo, the cutting-edge whole-body MRI scan that's flipping healthcare on its head. And since I always say early detection saves lives, I'm putting that to the test with my very own scan. Is this game-changing technology actually overhyped, or is it truly worth your hard-earned dollars? We'll break it all down. Plus, we'll check in on my own health, see if everything is running smoothly, or if I am a walking red flag. All right, let's dive right in. Prenuvo scan is basically a deep health audit, but without the poking, prodding, or anything invasive. It's an MRI scan that covers your entire body, looking for things like early stage cancer, liver disease, you name it. In fact, this scan can catch around 500 different conditions. 1 in 20 people who get this scan find something that could be life-saving. That's why I even got my wife to do it too. All right, let's head to the office. So you might be wondering what the different image modalities are and do, right? So let's start out with the basics. X-rays, which is a little bit of radiation. It looks for bone or infection or fractures. Then CT scans. This is radiation as well, but say a lot of X-rays, typically hundreds of X-rays to formulate a cross-sectional 3D view of your body, really good for looking at bleeding or infections. So that leads us to an MRI, which uses magnets and radio waves to formulate an image. And this is really good for soft tissue things, such as your brain, joints, just looking for tumors. And there's no radiation exposure. So where does Prenuvo fit in all of this? So it is a full body MRI, unlike the MRIs that we get at the hospital, which are basically body part specific. Prenuvo uses it for the whole body and it doesn't use any contrast. So you did this scan before me. I was stuck at the hospital working. How was your experience? How'd it go? Were you anxious?
Yes. I have had an MRI before when I had meningitis a number of years ago, and I couldn't make it through the entire scan. I got freaked out, got out of it halfway through, so I was very nervous to say the least.
MRIs are not a patient's favorite experience in the medical healthcare. The traditional MRI is loud and banging and boring, and you're just laying there in your own thoughts like, if I move, am I gonna fail the test? How was your experience here though?
So comparing it to before, it was completely different. Plus, they've got Netflix inside, so I got to just lay there and watch a show, and it was less crazy to me.
So even before you got the scan, how was the check-in process?
I didn't have to fill out that much paperwork. They asked me a few questions, pretty straightforward, like do you have any metal plates in your head, that sort of thing, yeah. Previous surgeries, and easy breezy check-in, got my sweet scrubs, and that was it. Off to the races, into the MRI. All right, how was it? Serious question, what did you watch in there? Dr. Yaron repeat?
No.
Serious question though, I feel like this is such a good thing to be preventative. Why wouldn't other doctors want this type of scanning?
So it's a huge debate because there's a concern of overdiagnosing, of doing too many extra studies, doing invasive procedures, and you know, then it would potentially also increase healthcare costs. There's so many different facets to this topic. And on another side is the mental health component of it is if you find something, there is the added stress of, oh my gosh, what do I do now? Is this something that's going to kill me or is this something so benign that I don't need to worry about?
But as the worrier of this relationship, I feel like for me, I would rather find it as stage one,
right,
as opposed to when you see them come into the ER,
right,
they come in for like a bellyache and it's like, oh, it's stage four cancer because they've never had that scan. I would rather be preventative, but that's just my personality.
We also have to note that this does not replace the normal screening for cancer, such as mammograms or colonoscopies. It doesn't take the place of it.
1 week later.
All right, we got the results. You can see everything from nervous system to reproductive, musculoskeletal, from your head to your toes, it shows you everything.
Here's mine. Okay, there's a lot of different things on here, a lot of minor findings, no findings, and then there's a moderate finding, like super detailed. So click on the spine and here we go. We have
a minor finding, whatever that means.
And a very long word. spondyloarthropathy of the cervical spine. So basically this is meaning that I have, here we go, mild degeneration, changes to my cervical spine. So it's basically like an extra bone growth on the backside that's just potentially pushing on the spinal cord, but I have no symptoms. It's probably my posture or previous injury that I've had. The only way for me to really know if it's something really worrisome is to then recheck it later on. Is it getting worse or is it staying the same and just keep doing what I'm doing? So at the moment, there's nothing to do with that. So I got another minor finding in the lumbar spine, which I have back pains. And you can see that there's like a little nubbins that are pushing into the white. So that's pushing into the spinal column, but not necessarily the spine itself. And so what does the finding say? It's mild degenerative changes with mild disc bulging and a little bit onto the right. So these are structural changes to my lower back.
Another minor finding.
So we go into the respiratory section. Okay, so it's telling me I have a deviated septum.
Holy nose, Batman!
That's there.
That's a deviated septum if I've ever seen one. That is a detour getting onto the freeway set.
No problem. So I probably had this my whole life and it's... I probably accommodated for it, but if I want to get it fixed, a surgeon can go and do a septoplasty basically and fix that. But it's not causing me any issues now, not worried about it, just cool finding about myself. And then here's a moderate finding. So here's one a little bit more pay attention to, okay, related to thyroid. So it's just showing I have a couple nodules in the thyroid. Here, I'm in the 1 to 1.5 centimeter size nodules. They didn't say it was suspicious for mass thyroid cancer or anything like that. I think what the next step is just to follow it, make sure it's not growing using the thyroid ultrasound. And worst case scenario later, if it changes or whatnot, it even says it here, you can do a fine needle aspiration.
The silver lining is you have this photo. So in whatever time it takes you to do another image, you can see the difference in sizing.
Yep, or it might go away. So also the other component of this, I have no symptoms. I have normal thyroid. It's all normal. And then we got some other skeletal stuff going on. Hips and pelvis. What do we got?
We see the red circle. It's a minor finding. What do we see here?
So they're saying that I have mild degenerative change to the femoral acetabular articulation of the right hip. So you can see that it's not exactly equivalent. And I've always had a little bit of right leg shorter than the left leg. So there's some... probably compensation going on.
Oh, so workout.
Workout, just be aware of this, that I need to continue to strengthen all the areas around. And then final impressions, okay, cool. No evidence of cancer, bilateral thyroid nodules, largest, which is in the right lobe, degenerative changes to spine and right hip, and then incidental findings. They say follow up in 2 years. Unless there's anything else going on.
It's nice that they write up the report and really spell it out for you.
So they give you the option of getting all your images if you want, in case you needed to maybe take it to your doctor or something like that.
All in all, I mean, it seems like you're pretty healthy. You have a few moderate findings, but it doesn't sound like, you know, any dreaded C words or...
No, and, you know, it helps to realize, oh, okay, there are some structural changes that I just need to be aware of and make sure I don't, you know, have anything worse happen.
Yeah.
All right, well, this is my scan. Let's check out your scan.
So, here we go.
We got a lot of information, and we have one minor and 2 mod.
Here we go. Oh.
Oh, look, you're trying to copy me.
Why you gotta be like me? Indeterminate thyroid nodule.
On the right, too. Interesting. For yours, you have 1, and it's less than 1 centimeter for
it
now.
It says nothing to do given the size, but do another scan maybe in a year or two.
How do you feel about that?
You know, it's okay. I'm glad to know that it's there, and I'm glad that they're not like, get it out immediately.
Right. Yes! Oh! All right, what's this other finding we got here? We have a hypodense subcutaneous infiltration of the right axilla. So it's 4 centimeters, so it's not small, but it's not massive. You've had discomfort in that area for a long time?
I have, which is super interesting because 5 years ago-ish, I felt something in my armpit. I went to the doctor, not you.
Yep, yep.
And they said, oh, we don't see anything. This is proving otherwise, what?
Maybe when they say they don't find anything specifically abnormal on an ultrasound, maybe that's what they're trying to tell you, but not saying it in so many nice words. Yes, we will go get an ultrasound of this and we will also talk to a specialist about it. All right, so those are your 2 moderate findings. Let's see what else you got. Respiratory finding. Mastoiditis, that's weird, okay.
I don't know where mastoid is,
oh, good.
To be honest.
So
but
behind your ear?
Yeah.
This is the hard bone is your mastoid.
Boop, boop. I don't have pain in that spot, but I always kind of have weird sensation in my ears, specifically my left one because I perforated it, my eardrum back in the day.
So it says it's consistent with a small amount of fluid in the mastoid air cells. So it's not specific, especially since you're not symptomatic, but it could be helpful in the future. If you get an infection, you have pain there, then we know you potentially could get infection and might need antibiotics. And can be due to recent air pressure changes, travel. But it says basically, if you're having symptoms of like an infection, go see your doctor, which is good.
Final impressions. I guess the biggest thing is I need to watch that nodule, just like you.
Yep.
Thyroid partners in crime here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we'll see what the other doctors say, but I would say overall,
You're doing great.
Overall, what did you think of the findings from a doctor medical standpoint?
The report was really good. I actually explained it nicely and actually went into further detail. So this is good for somebody who's maybe having some kind of non-specific health issues or very anxious about their health care and they want to get checked out and they want the peace of mind.
Yeah, I think having the peace of mind is really helpful for me as mm-hmm. somebody who has maybe suspected something going on. You suspected your back issues
right.
and now you know really the extent of it.
Correct.
I think doctors sometimes don't love that.
Yeah, so doctors typically don't like it because they think it might be over investigating something or that you're going to find something that's not worrisome but then turn into something that's worrisome and then increase anxiety and possible further investigation, maybe unwarranted tests or surgeries, those sorts of things.
But on the flip side, if you find something early and it's stage one as opposed to stage four when you actually get symptoms, maybe it will save healthcare costs in the long run.
Which is why the whole reason why they have this.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty pricey. It was $2,500. But if you are concerned about something specific going on in your body or you want that peace of mind, I think this could be very beneficial.
Right. So your health is your most valuable thing that you own. So if you find that this is really important to you, I think it gives a good option for individuals and good insight. You know, be proactive, stay healthy, do everything you can from a lifestyle standpoint. And since we did this and we helped make a video with Prenuvo, they've offered anybody watching this a discount code. So you can do Dr. ER. It's $300 off if you're interested. We'll put it in the description below for you.
Hopefully that comes in handy if you want to do this. Let us know if you get a scan like this. We would definitely love to hear what your experience was like. I loved it. I thought they were super nice. And even though they found something and I'm not loving that, I do think it's really great.
Right, and we're gonna follow up appropriately. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Definitely binge watch this playlist right here. And as always, do me a favor, make sure you subscribe, turn your bell notifications on, and hit that like button for me. Thank you so much for watching.
And stay healthy, my friends.